A new study shows people who recovered from the COVID-19 variant first detected in South Africa may have better immunity against other virus mutations. According to a group of South African scientists who first identified the variant, plasma collected from the people who have recovered from the virus mutation could very well neutralize the virus and potentially other variants of concern. This raises hopes that vaccines modeled on the South African variant could protect against future mutations. Vaccine manufacturers are now racing to tweak their formulas after several studies found some of them to be less effective against newer coronavirus variants. Philippine researchers believe the country's capital region is now in the early stages of a potentially serious surge in COVID-19 cases. They suspect this is driven by new coronavirus variants that may threaten the government's vaccination program. Rafael Bosan reports.
Even before the Philippine Genome Center detected the more transmissible South African variant of the coronavirus, experts have already observed a noticeable increase in the number of COVID-19 cases in some parts of the country. In the capital region, several local governments have seen a sudden spike in COVID cases over a period of 2 weeks. These include Manila, Quezon City, Makati, and Pasay, the city where 4 of the 6 cases of the South African variant were detected.
If we look at specifically some of these LGUs, like Pasay, this is the rate of increase that we're seeing in Pasay, and it's very significant. So in the early weeks of February, they were averaging only 20 cases per day. And now the average is, well, you can see it's around 150 almost. It's a very fast rise.
The reproduction number should ideally be below 1. But what is concerning is that the reproduction number in Pasay is above 2, while for the rest of the capital region, the figure is at 1.36. The Health Department's Epidemiology Bureau says more than 90% of the areas in Pasay have logged at least 1 new case. For the Octo Research Group, the detection of not just 1 but 2 variants is something that should keep everyone on their toes.
We are number 1 in a early stage of a potentially serious surge. New variants that are game-changing variants, not only because they're more contagious, not only because they're more lethal, but they have a significant implication on the rollout of our very important vaccination program.
Aside from the increased transmissibility of the South African variant, studies have shown that it can also affect the efficacy of the AstraZeneca vaccine.
The efficacy of the AstraZeneca vaccine against B1351 dramatically decreases from 70% to 10%. And basically, South Africa decided to abandon the AstraZeneca vaccine because it was no different than injecting water into the patients.
This is important information as the Philippine government and the private sector have purchased vaccines from AstraZeneca.
If we do not eliminate the B1351 variant in the Philippines, the 17 million doses of AstraZeneca that we have already bought but have not yet arrived will be ineffective against fighting this particular variant from South Africa.
The DOH has yet to confirm whether a local transmission of the South African variant has occurred in Pasay. But for the Octo Group, it isn't impossible that the increase in cases is due to the presence of new variants.
We suspect that some of these variants, the two variants, may be driving the infection or the increase in COVID-19 infections in many of the LGUs observed.
Whatever variant may become dominant, experts remind the public that adherence to minimum public health standards is still the only way to keep oneself safe. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
After 6 straight days with over 2,000 new COVID-19 cases daily, the Philippines recorded a slightly lower number of new coronavirus infections on Wednesday. 1,783 new infections were recorded, bringing the total number of cases in the country past 582,000. More than 35,000 of them are considered active cases. The health department also reported 20 more fatalities and 330 additional recovered patients. But today's tally does not include data from 7 laboratories that failed to submit the results on time.